Hi viewers, welcome to today's training. Today we shall be looking at refund and credits module in QuickBooks. You can find it on the window screen here under customer center or under customer module here on the navigation bar. To locate it, you come to manage transaction here. Then here you have credit memos and refunds. Another way we can look for it is to come to the tax bar at the top menu here. Then there we have create credit memos or refund. And today we shall be looking at this customer, Chris. Let's look at the customer's invoice. The customer purchased this item, 3 units. And this item, under socks, 2 units. So the item number one here is sold at the rate of 50,000, and the second item was sold at the rate of 45,000. So now, assuming the customer returned all this item or part of the items after paying for the item, and we want to refund the customer. So to do that, we will be using credit and refund module here. So you select this button, refund and credit. You select the customer's name. Select the date the item was returned. Now you select the items here. So this is the item. Select the shop or the location where the item was sold from. We didn't charge tax, so you remove tax. Now you are going to put the quantity the customer returned, assuming the customer returned 1 out of the 3 purchased. Then from the second item as well, the customer returned parts. Assuming from this item also, the customer returned 1 piece, and the item was sold at the rate of 45,000. We remove tax since we did not charge tax. So now here we have the credit memo. Then you select save and close. Close this. And now this window will pop up to ask you, do you want to retain as an available credit, give a refund, or apply to an invoice? What this simply means is that we have 3 options on how to use the customer's credits. So you now decide, are you going to retain the item based on your discussion with the customer? Are you going to retain the item, credit in the customer's account, or you are going to issue a check to refund the customer for the amount due on this return, which is 95,000, or you want to apply it to an existing invoice which the customer has not paid? So here now we are going to retain it in the customer's account as available credit. So you click OK. So now let's go to the customer center again. Here, click on this customers. Then you come to customers account here. So as you can see, we have credit memo that states the total value of what the customer returned. So now let's quickly look at the customers accounts. You can right click on this. You can click on quick reports. So here now you can see the invoice issued to the customer, the payment made on the 5th, then the item returned by the customer. So now let's look at another customer using the same model. So we use the first option, which is to retain the item in the customer's account, which is 95,000. And if you look at the customer's account here, Chris, you will see that it's having a negative balance of 95,000, which means that the customer has money with us. So anytime the customer is coming to buy another item, he can use this credit to offset the invoice. So now let's look at another customer here. Let's look at Ken Limited. Ken Limited purchased this item. Let's open. So here we have this item purchased, three quantity at this amount, 39,999, and he purchased three pieces of it. So now let's go and use our refund and credit again. You select the module, then you select the customer's name, Ken Limited. Now, if you look at it, the item was bought on the 5th of November. Then he bought item number 6. So this is the item. Select the shop. The quantity returned. She's one. Remove tax. And here now, it says save and close. So now we are going to use the second option, which is give a refund. So we select that and you click OK. Then this window will pop up for you. So the window is asking us, where are we paying from? We are paying from Zenith Bank to issue a check. Then you can put a memo here, refund to Ken Limited on invoice number let's check the invoice number. You can print this out. If you don't want to print, maybe you want to send a soft copy to the customer, you can check this and you click OK. So now you can see the customer's account now is showing that a credit memo of 39,999 has been refunded to the customer. So the balance to be paid by the customer now is 119,997. So as you can see, the customer has a past due invoice of 119,997. So let's go and receive payments for this. So receive payments on the available balance. Then you come to receive payments. Select the customer. The amounts. Then select the payment dates. Where are you paying from? Select the bank you are paying from. then the mode of payments, either check, cash, credit or debit card. Then select it. Now let's go and check the customer's accounts. The customer's account is now showing zero amount. That is, we are no more owing the customer. So now let's use the third option. Refund and credits. And let's choose this customer, Patrick. We can minimize this. Check the customer's invoice. Double click on this. We have this item, item number 5. Item, the quantity purchased is 2. So let's go back to our credit memo. Select a shop. Quantity returned. Remove tax. And select the return dates. Now you can. So now you save and close. And this window will pop up again. So we are going to use the third option, apply to an invoice, and select OK. Then list of outstanding invoices will pop up here. So assuming we are using it to offset this, you can select this. But if you want to use it to offset part of this, you can select this. So assuming we want to select this, then you click on done. Then you come back to the customer's center. And here now you have credit memo, 78,000 credits, which has already been used to offset part of the outstanding invoices. Thank you for watching. So please like and share. And you can put your comments in the comment section in case you have any question or you need further video on this. Then don't forget to click on the notification button so that you can always have access to our next videos. Subscribe to the channel, like and share. Thank you very much.